get the exact price of the 50 kg rice? Like,
Of
for
course.
example, parboiled rice, what are the cost?
I'd expect, say, the 50 kg parboiled rice at as today inside Freetown here for the in between anything around 350 to
This
360.
is not expectation. Let me look at the
That is
reality
what
on the
I'm
ground.
saying. That is what I'm saying.
Not what
I
he
mean,
expects now, what's in there on the ground.
Yeah.
I may not have got the information right now, as I tell you, but based on waiting the wholesale price of rices, I'd expect the rice in price now, Freetown, that parboiled rice one I'm talking about, for the between 350, depending on where you are, to
But you know, so that price is not showing the reality in terms of the cost.
You not get for tell me. I mean,
the price down at 5, 5, 10, 5, 20.
That is not true.
As recent
that,
as
I can
it can
tell
be.
You that one they say it's not true. I mean, this is exaggeration. That rice, the parboiled rice, one bag rice, at 5, 20. That is not true.
It's fact, Mr. Minister. I go to the ground. When
no,
you left
I,
here,
I
go to a different shop. They may ask.
I would challenge you on that. That is not true.
Okay.
That rice, a bag of rice, they go at
yes.
500.
Okay.
It's not,
it
look,
is true.
It depends on also maybe. I mean, if you talk about parboiled rice, you talk about butter brand rice, you talk about Big Joe. It can never be even
okay.
up to 400.
Let me look at Monday, December 6, 2021. Welcome to the first edition of the program Good Morning Saloon for this week, where they come to you from the Society for Radio Democracy 98.1 FM. We where they bring you this Monday edition of the program Good Morning Saloon. Musa Kamara na my name.
And me, Nasapti Kalon. Good morning.
Inside the program, we go talk to the Minister of Trade, Dr. Inga Sandi. We go talk about plan them with the ministry don't put together for get better price control na the country. As then at the ministry, we are in charge of trade and industry, we go ensure say things them available na market for people them and available at reasonable price where people will able afford them. But what in the ministry don't they do over the past years them and months now? We get the minister inside the program, Dr. Sandi. Once more, good morning and welcome to the program.
Good morning.
As I tell listeners, them you did inside the program for tell people within the Ministry of Trade, don't they do for ensure say when I get control of the prices them and ensure say things them available at the market and at reasonable price. Taking from that introduction, way I don't tell listeners them, take me through some of the recent happenings and activities of the Ministry of Trade in this direction, as I mentioned exactly.
Well, thank you very much. We all don't see waiting on the happen. In the last one or so years, we also don't see how much COVID alone don't impact on the global logistics. We make freight charges then go up. Some countries even they find it difficult for make sure say they get sufficient stockpile of essential commodities. So which we try for do as a government, working together with all other institutions, we able get the Bank of Sierra Leone for. Open a facility where they support importers of essential commodities, and the CSA, because of that, we get sufficient stockpile of some of their essential commodities here, yeah. Rice, flour, etc., etc. So the CSA then kind of support they have really they help for boost. In fact, Boko people being surprised. I mean, based on the intervention we'll do, we then see, for instance, parboiled rice, we then see been on the go up to 500,000. And as you say, the price don't they come down. Right now, the wholesale price of parboiled rice, they're around 335,000. And you also they see the other rice, them like the Chinese round rice, the what they call the butter brand, they have the price and don't they come down. So you did notice, say, indeed, we put them, they talk, say, price and they go up. Once price and go up, now this country price and don't they come down. We all understand saying, the freights then we've been on the go. Once we don't begin to see the freights and on the can down, and I'm sure as we go into the new year, we see better improvement in the freights.
For we listeners, them, let me explain exactly what in them freight charges and the connection to the prices them we you don't talk about
well,
all the time.
Well, freight now the money we give the shipper for bring come the commodity side buying. Till we say you are making go. And then I call freight. In other words, like we they say transport. If you don't buy rest from Freetown, you want carry and go bow, for instance, the money we give the transporter. Say yeah, care go this rest, go bow. So that's the same as freight. We don't see me, don't they go up. Take for instance, we took in the talk. cement. Today, before COVID, the freight for one metric ton of cement, essentially now like 20 bag cement, from Turkey to Sierra Leone, today we're going to pay $20. Recently, over the months, now I don't come down small, small, but over the months, we see saying can up to $72. So now that making the see cement in price being on the go. That before don't lead to shortage. But we will try for do, we support the importers, we continue for deal with them and give them the assurances because we need enough stock of them cement in there. And better make you get enough stock, even when the freights don't go, people then we want to use and they're able to get time than in order at all. If there was a shortage in the market, it was going to hit everybody very, very badly. But now we don't see the freights in the calm down, you see back say adjustments and on the day. And we will continue for push on through. The Ministry of Trade and Industry in Dome finally passed the consumer protection law.
Before we go to that, Mr. Minister, I'd like to bring you back a little bit. You talk about essential commodities being, affordable and the sufficient one at the market. Let's look at the affordability in terms of the cost of the essential goods here.
Affordability.
You talk about it, and it's sufficient, and then at the country, yeah, people want them, and they get them.
Yeah,
so when are the cost of it here, so?
So, well, I mean, you have to be very, very realistic. Unfortunately, we've been finding ourselves in a situation over the years. We've not been on try for developing industries. You see, say most of it we use in the country, they actually they come out from other countries. And then kind of situation there definitely make we all vulnerable to any external shock. So as the freights in the go up, the cost of the commodities then also we inside and they produce them because energy price also don't go up, it definitely go impact on the actual price of them commodities there. So if somebody go buy, for instance, a metric ton of cement at $50, then in pay a freight charge of $70, we take the total cost to $120. When come, we all sit down with them. We look at the breakdown, we look at the cost, we look at the margin, and able to determine what it will be, for instance, the wholesale price, what it will be the retail price, and then they will be on the do. But like I tell you, as the freights in the can down, definitely they notice the cost of bringing the cement to Sierra Leone, definitely get for reduce. Would they look at how would they reduce the prices?
So let me come out from the issue of building materials because obviously not everybody didn't construct in yes and no. But look at things the way people need in their everyday life, like rice, oil, and other things the way you mentioned in terms of their prices. Because you don't announce price, but when people are going to the market at the business center, them it's different from waiting the ministry go don't pull out.
No, that's not true. When you talk about the wholesale prices. And the retail prices and the way would they try for see, I mean, in some cases, it becomes very, very, very difficult for make you able to go after everybody with the retail for make sure, say, they sell price, sorry, they sell certain commodities at a particular price. I mean, because some man will say, oh, and honestly, as I tell you, we get trade monitors, but the trade monitors are not sufficient. For the whole country, we get around 70-something trade monitors. You want to imagine? If you distribute all end trade monitors there, even if you do it evenly across the country, you're not going to have more than 4 trade monitors in every district. But now that makes you see we come up with this consumer protection group where we don't already pass in parliament, president don't sign the law, and we make sure so we rule the outfit inside this January. We don't make provision for that. That particular group, Nainga, will be taxed with the responsibility for go around, not only with prices, even with the quality of the commodities, that they therefore make sure say they're able to ensure say the one that they sell them goods in the able to sell them at good prices and also.
I'll take you back to the prices of rice where you mentioned earlier, where you see being there above 500. That depends to who say you they buy them from. I can tell you, say, rice now, they're above 400,000, 50 kg. You have to say the bam. Sometimes it's 430,000 in some places, well, and sometimes it's above that. You talk about 300,000, slightly above 300,000. What exactly do they talk about?
The wholesale price. Now I tell you about buying the rice from CTC. I mean, what don't they do? We get price control at two levels. We get price control at the wholesale. When I am looking able to sit down with the importers, then we take a look at all their costs. And finally, able to determine what thing will be the wholesale price. And then we get price control also, or price regulation also, at the retail level. For making able to control prices at the retail level is quite challenging. Of course, you will need a whole lot of battalion of price control people, them, or even trade monitors, them, for able go around and able determine waiting people then they sell at retail. But I tell you, inside Freetown here, I mean, if you buy, for instance, the CTC Parberize, that Bella, within the sale of 335,000, would expect, say, if you pay transport safe within Freetown here, weigh something, and they, you know, with anything above 5,000, you know, and go down with 340. If you put your margin at even 10,000, you've able to sell at 350,000.
This is not expectation or just imagination from this the Minister of Trade. Let me go down to the ground, to the, because the end buyers, them, now the matter now, not to the retails. If person they buy rest 430,000 leons, about 500,000, depending on who say it is, now serious issue. From the Ministry of Trade, from that wholesale to the retail, how do they monitor that chain of distribution for ensure say people can get the rice at affordable price?
Well, like I don't tell you, we depend do a lot of that. Which we don't try for do, first of all, now using which we get the trade monitors. And then they go out there. We don't monitor within the prices and the be. I mean, it's surprising that you will find yourself in some places and you then they sell rice then at 500 way. Actually, the wholesale price of the rice and the, as I tell you, the butter brand, the wholesale price currently, that's around 328,000. So if somebody buy them from here, some of the logistics the we don't do as a ministry of, as a ministry, in several areas. We get SLPMC, for instance, the Sierra Leone Produce Marketing Company. We don't open community stores then almost everywhere. That particular store, you see them, they sell the commodities and the particular rice at certain prices we all don't see them, we don't determine. And me go encourage people then. I mean, it happens, say, the trade monitors, as they are, with all the vigilance waiting they put into their efforts and when they do the work they want to do, you notice say we just can't reach everywhere. But definitely with the coming of the consumer protection group or the commission we don't set or this we will begin employment by January, you could definitely go for see the one there specifically they focus on which thing really they happen
so,
in the retail
so
world.
In line with this price control issue, Mr. Minister, in the first place, is there anything like price control in this country? Because most time you see private business people, they go tell you say now I go buy at the sale. It's like there is no structure at all.
No. I mean, I can understand where prices and they go up, and in some cases everybody go and blame on price control. But if you take a look at waiting, I do explain to you for some commodities where the freights don't go up, where even the actual cost of them commodities then we sign the manufacture them don't go up. In most cases, it's easy for make you fall back on the weakest link that there is no price control. But I will explain to you exactly that we do price control at two levels, the wholesale level and the retail level. And our unbelief say with all which we don't do, you don't really see say the movements and what don't they make, they really get towards having an institution where we will really take over the entire price control at the retail level. When I tell you say we get challenges with, because we trade monitors then we'll get in as much as then they try as much as they do, they are not just sufficient for making them able to cover every part of the country. And that make we still they even engage the traders union, the one that within the inside business, make we see and talk to them. We have been doing this all throughout the year. Me and the Minister of Information, we don't go out around the country, we talk to their stakeholders and they explain to them which and waiting we don't do as an intervention. And if we see we don't able to get them in control at the wholesale level, you notice say a lot is being done for make we see say. I mean, the fact is still that prices of commodities plus the freights them we need to pay for men come with them, it really, really don't go up. But the other intervention we don't do, even with vegetable oil, what happened for say now Sierra Leone within the sub-region now we sell the cheapest vegetable oil, waiting to because we get sucked where they produce palm oil now. Now we no need for import crude palm oil for coming to this country. And we also get two companies in way they refine vegetable oil. If you see, say, the paddy vegetable oil, although the prices don't go up, but relatively compared to waiting they happen at the sub-region, the vegetable oil are the cheapest in this country.
Okay, continue for the week. In case you just are tuning, you're listening to the Minister of Trade and Industry, Edward Inga Sandi, where they give updates on different things, where people forget access to winner commodities, where people they need now their everyday life, and how they don't put measures in place for ensure say pricing in a way we go make people afford them commodities. Yeah, the program Good Morning Salon, they continue. We will bring this first edition for this week come to you this Monday morning. My name is Saptiu Kalon.
And Musa Kamara, my name.
Well, inside the program now, we continue with you studio guest, we are the Minister of Trade and Industry, Edward Inga Sandi. We so far, we don't start for the update for talk about the thing that the ministry done, they put in place as we for ensure say commodity they are accessible and affordable for all manner the country. Mr. Minister, before we go for a break, you will talk about price control and also you will talk about trade monitors that we can go out for check out for price and also how the quality of the goods. So in terms of the reality on the ground, waiting you can get from there your different trade monitors here, we can go out. How you go ensure see waiting and tell you the reality. May question a little, when you don't ever take upon yourself and decide for go out and check things for yourself, especially if you hear so much grumble from the public.
Of course.
When recently you go out?
I mean, the last time me and the Minister of Information go out, we go na Gambia, we go na Bombali, we don't go na Bo, we don't do na Kenema, Kailan, we don't talk with the Traders Union, we also go to the markets, we talk with the people. We try to understand what they go on there. And I tell you, I mean, with all the efforts there, you realize, say, with all which we do gradually as the fritz and the can down, you will see definitely what will get for happen to the prices. And man, I can give you, I mean, we miss have the plan for Duam on the ground of Freetown here. And we get a couple of other interventions, and what would they do? As I speak to you, we get a number of people them way also to go out there. They check what they actually happen at the market. So apart from the trade monitors telling us what are the actual prices of commodities in the market, we also get people in where they give with feedback.
So when you get the exact price of the 50 kg rice, like for example, parboiled rice, what are the cost?
I'd expect, say, the 50 kg parboiled rice at as today inside Freetown here for day in between anything around 350 to 360.
This is not expectation. Let me look at the reality on the ground.
That is what I'm saying.
It's not what you expect now. What's in there on the ground?
Yeah.
I may not have got the information right now, as I tell you, but based on waiting the wholesale price of rices, I'd expect the rice in price now, Freetown, that parboiled rice, what are you talking about? For the between 350, depending on where you are, to 360.
But you know, so that price is not so in the reality in terms of the cost.
You not get for tell me. I mean,
the price on a 5, 10, 5, 20.
That is not true.
As recent as it can be.
The one they say is not true. I mean, this is exaggeration. That rice, the parboiled rice, one bag rice, na 520. That is not true. I mean, easy for me to even direct them. Go right down opposite bus station. And then get their own small retailer than they.
But if person neighbor go yonder, not to pass Usauna Wale person by more its neighbor.
Not to me, they tell you, say, make you go on a bus station. But I'm just making a reference that if it is there at that price, and when I then the retail, and you get a couple of other retail outlets, then for tell me, say, rice now 520. That
is fact, Mr. Minister. I go to the ground where you left here, I go to different shop them and ask.
I would challenge you on that is not true.
Okay.
That rice, a bag of rice that go at 500, okay, it's not true. It depends on also, maybe, I mean, if you talk about parboiled rice, you talk about butter brand rice, you talk about Big Joe, it can never be even
okay,
up to 400.
Let me look at the prices depends to who say you there at the moment and who say you there buy them from. Let's take example, for instance, we need a buy rest a bag. Now, 430,000 leones, for instance, places like Lungi. So, going to places far from French communities, that was 2 weeks back. Mm-hmm. So that's the price we, for instance, buy. Mm-hmm. Going to the far-flung communities, you can't despise the fact that you know go reach to 500,000.
I will tell you, see, all across the country, except if you talk about then other high-end rice, like jasmine. But there is no way anybody will sell rice. Now, any part of this country have up to even 500,000.
But I'm talking what about the 430?
No, well, 430, depending on, like I also say, depending on the kind of rice. But honestly, if you are saying that somebody is selling rice at 430, you are buying the wholesale price. More say, even up to last week, the price was around 340,000 years. When I've been arguing, they don't come with, I mean, it was all over on social media that wholesale price of rice is at 340,000. You can't tell me even paying transport to whichever part of the country you go, finally go sell that rice at 340 or 330.
Mr. Minister, even if you they say that is not true, we actually that that's not the girl. You know, things say for the fact that we know the produce to we own. For the fact that we know the produce to we own, and you serve your attest now, you say freight they go up. You know, things say people they do business for loss. And for the fact that we not get a proper we not get a proper price monitoring mechanism in place.
But you go say obviously you people price, and go, I mean, these are all, I mean, I think say this are outlandish assumptions.
Really. This is not just fact. You it just state here, say the price monitors they know they will reach all side, the price, the trade monitors, and then they will go outside.
It is not, if it is not fact. I don't tell you, say, we get price control at two levels, the wholesale price. And with the insurance, say, we also get their community stores, there with SLPMC, the one across the country. We also get good business people, them. We're really not going to go buy rice at a wholesale price of 340 or 335. Go, Alec, now, Kailan, you can go sell and the 430.
So almost for Jasmine rice.
So, I mean,
50 kg.
No, I'm not going to tell you about just, I mean, more not reduce this thing to that.
This is about, so, Mr. Minister, no, we look at.
More not reduce this discussion.
No, we look at.
We go begin to ask me,
no, we look at.
This, right,
but you need for now as a Minister of Trade.
No, but
you for able to tell the public.
This is what I'm telling you. We concern about the products that we most of Sierra Leoneans, 80 to 90% of Sierra Leoneans, able to consume. So, you know, you can begin ask me how much Toyota, for instance. When it comes to vehicle, how much Toyota they cost, how much Ferrari they cost. I'm telling you about waiting most of the people in the consume. Nobody in the right senses, no will left so, price of rice weight and they buy, look, for instance, the butter brand at maybe 340, 350 for go buy jasmine rice. Except if not that you they eat.
But you need for let the people know. No, because why people they know you they guide people for say if you go here, you mean a surprise.
This Monday morning, we just come up from the weekend. By the time I get to my office, I think, say, I'll get forget the breakdown of prices of the essential commodities. So, and trust me, as you don't say, I'm going to look, and maybe I'll get for even come back, if you allow me for come back on the station, not tomorrow, and actually maybe take me and you go to the street, more go check, waiting really the price of the commodities.
Let me look at the other one way they raise concern, where now the issue of cement. I'm also not the price from the Ministry of Trade perspective for cement.
Good. Cement at wholesale price. I mean, consider how much people they buy now at Turkey at around $50. They consider how much they pay as freight, around $70. When you put down on the one price, even when you not pay maybe custom it. In fact, that's why government came in this year for look at how we will reduce the duty on cement. It used to be 20%. You see, government don't come. Come January, it's going to be the custom duty go for reduced to 10%. These are all things where the government is trying for do.
What's the price?
Well, it's the wholesale price is around 95,000. And you'd expect, say, as you take them out for go sell land, you pay transport, you get your margin. We'd expect, say, the price largely for cement for the between 100,000 to 110,000.
So it's 120,000 this cement. That's the price I'm telling you.
Then I was like, inside Mwamba, Usa just come out over the weekend. Cement they go at 110,000. So for me, you can't tell me say cement na fit on 120,000. That's what we even need for question.
So now we look at the issue of the cement production. We get Leosem and also we get Dangote with the bag the cement na salon. Looking at the Leosem, issues don't come up, and even some people say Leosem don't close and Hardbag don't sell their own share. You are aware of any of the issues here with Apple Naden, at the cement factory, with the supply salon, majority of the cement that people buy?
Well, we get Leosem, where, like you rightly say, in Heisenberg, get them, where they're based in Germany. They've been having a lot of challenges. I mean, a very, very old factory. I mean, this is something which we should have done long, long ago. We should have got a number of cement factories in this country over the years. But we know, I mean, as a government, as a country, we've not been able to do all internet. Now you see the efforts with government, this government they make for make sure say apart from Leosen, we're also able to get a number of other cement factories them located at the appropriate places. So you can see, say, with all the efforts there, I mean, unfortunately, some of the very key raw materials we in the use of produce cement, we not get there. So a lot of people we go, even the plan for go inside cement production, we'll get to look at importing clinker when are the one of the core raw materials, plus the stone dust will get now, the granite dust will get now. I think so. Once we're able to get them factories and they're running now, and look at what we don't do, even with the with industry, we don't get two factories then where they recycle currently, where they can build them factories then for recycle scrap metals into steel rods. We also don't get in the medium term then two factories then I don't commit for able to extract iron from even iron ore. So with all anything that we do and the special economic zone policy, we government plan for rollout, you really see, say, these are all drives where they make sure, say, we begin to look at what we still be able to produce at this country.
So what in the future hold for people we want going to building in the issue of cement, where the producer, where people know over the years, you self don't mention, say, don't they get challenged? Some people where they're into building, what do they expect coming into the, or going in into the future in terms of cement production and buying.
Sierra Leone is not isolated. For Sierra Leone, an isolated country. I mean, we get things and we will sell the produce where other people and they buy from. We sell get things that where other people and they produce where they buy from them. So that should not be the question. Okay. We as a government, they work very, very hard for make sure say we get them factories then.
Okay.
And if Leosem don't, they get problem, we definitely they expect more and more people. And when you take a look at what you've been talking about Leosem, there's going to be a reinvestment if there's going to be a buyout of the shares of Heisenberg.
So okay.
Whosoever they come inside, they try to make sure, say, we're able to make that factory they run and able
to
make
profit. Mr. Minister, continue for the week till they come back to
you. The program now, good morning, Salon. We come to you from 98.1 FM. We still got the Minister of Trade, Dr. Edward Inga Sandi. They talk about the issues or the measures that we don't put in place for price control. Before we go for that break, they talk about one essential commodity where people don't raise concern about when are the cement, and you make mention of the striped moon I don't they take and hope for come with more factories them. Before the factories them come in place, what in are the striped them way the Minister of Trade don't take for ensure say the commodity available in the market and at reasonable price?
No, it's available in the market. What you call reasonable price? Now, something we're subject to people their own judgment. But when they look at waiting people and they buy the cement at overseas, and you can't realize, say, even the cement with Dangote they come with now, imported cement. Now, bag them when they come back. And, so he's also buying it at how it's being sold in Turkey. You take a look at waiting, Maki themselves, they do themselves. Now, buying they go buy from Turkey, then pay ship, come with them. So, and this is not only happening in Sierra Leone here. It's happening across the globe. It's happening. I mean, we go to Geneva for go get the World Trade Conference last week. After we don't spend all the time with energy, we don't reach Geneva. Last minute, they close the conference and postpone it because of COVID. And then begin stop people even from entering into Geneva. Imagine these are people. So if you begin look at waiting at the steps then where them countries and they take. For even make people now they say some people if you not get vaccine, I went to a supermarket, a restaurant for go sit down for drink coffee. They told me if I not present evidence, say I've got double vaccination, they not go admit me to the internet. So if you see all these things that they happen, you should know that those places where these goods and produce them, definitely they put measures in place. Will really they help them for control the spread of the virus. And because of this, the way it don't affect the logistics chain, except if one for peace says Sierra Leone is isolated or Sierra Leone is one on its own. While this they happen at Sierra Leone, it not they happen at any other country. So take a look at prices of commodities, even in our neighboring countries. Don't go far. Guinea, Liberia. You go realize, say, some of the things the world don't do, now the best thing we any government able to do at this very difficult time. For make sure say we're able to get even the importers get the confidence for importing more good
citizens. So we listeners, one of our listeners, they say cement is still 120 since the price skyrocketed from 85 or 90,000. They ask what did the ministry do, and in Bayam last week na Kington Bridge 120, and Bayam Saturday again na PMB na the Eastern Partner Freetown 120.
But I don't tell you waiting at the price of I mean, like when I don't bring and come up, so we got for cancer done now with the trade monitors as well. We're going to, I mean, particularly during this festive season, we're going to mount an operation where we go right round and check the retail prices of them commodities there. But as I speak to you, the wholesale price of cement right now is 95,000 based on all the cost analysis we're done. Now, taking it from here to any partner of the country, when you consider the transfer to EDP, plus your profit way the retail assessment go for make, you'd expect them for the anywhere between, for instance, 110, 115, 120, so to some extreme places.
So
as I talk to you, looking at all of that, we don't look at the wholesale price. We try to determine what will be the possible retail price depending on wherever that the country you find yourself.
So, Mr.
And as I've been to speak to you, coming back from cement, I just don't get one retailer. Don't send text message to me. Right now, as in this retail right now, the OAU rice, when another Chinese one rice, is going at 330,000 euros. The Paboy rice is going for 350,000 euros. And then the jasmine rice, where you see you buy 530, maybe you get
Bokumo. So outside this portion,
she's selling it at 365. It's
obviously the price.
How can that be this very, very large gap?
So
consider waiting 1% to sell 365, the jasmine rice that you were talking about. I know they even expect it within Freetown. Anybody go sell that same jasmine rice for even 380.
It all boils down to the issue of price control. Nobody nobody gets who that for control, who that for selling, how we for sell.
No, you can't say that. So we have trade price monitors control going out. We get trade monitors. As limited as the capacity is, we get still get trade monitors when they go out there. And once in a while, now they see the minister and says, when they come down, go to the street, they check for prices. And I know really what make we begin, except if now man preach a doomsday.
Mr. Minister,
you cannot tell me jasmine rice quoted on the mic.
So now let's look at affordability.
Rice sold in Freetown here for 530. It's not possible.
So let's look at affordability. Mm. Even the prices where you just give out, you think say affordable. It now some tea will be affordable of all Malek. Everybody go able to afford such amount.
We find ourselves in a very difficult situation, and if you want really ignore the fact, say where COVID don't come, it don't affect almost everything at the world, not only Sierra Leone, then I think there's something really wrong with the way they do their analysis.
So,
as far as it is, check what thing they happen in Guinea, check what thing they happen in Liberia, and you begin to realize, say, I mean, if we were producing enough in this country, look what you don't do with palm oil. While at the tribe for tell you, say, we are doing very well with vegetable oil within the sub-region. Now, because we have to produce enough palm oil and we don't get factories where they convert them palm oil into vegetable oil. So you can as well ask, these are all successes we, I believe, say, we've appointed. And we for indicate to, we say, if we all can come together, if more farming go on, if we try to focus on particularly on staple food and produce more, some of the challenges we they face right now, you cannot expect somebody go buy rice at a given price, then pay freight for it, come with time. Then you can tell and say, sell at 250,000.
Now,
that would be the most unfair thing where any government
Mr. Minister,
to any business.
So much has been said on price control, commodities, and affordability. Now, let's look at another very important issues, policy and legislative reforms. We see this being team. You don't even have parliament on different policy then.
We don't get a couple of policies. I mean, we all realize, say, the medium-term national development plan, especially where they're in line with the manifesto of His Excellency the President, don't they look at what to do with the rural economy, for rejuvenate the rural economy. Now, we don't come. A very, very old cooperative policy we've been only done for years, nobody not touch. We don't come, we don't review. And we don't begin to see cooperatives and don't begin come up, then don't begin show. We get credit unions, then we get cap assets we worth over $1 billion right now around across the country. And these are happening in the rural communities. You see, say, if you don't begin do them kind thing and they, waiting this, they really gravitate to, and for we're able to develop a cooperative bank. And we also try for look at the review of the cooperative policies. So that because these now mostly semi-informal sector, you really want to make sure, say, we get strong legislation. We will really make sure, say, the people, the money, and where they put inside certain cooperatives, and they, nobody know where we just easily go take and run away with them. So that's why we're building up the system. And we started with policy, we're moving on to the legislation, we see how we will build more cooperatives.
You take, for instance, an agro-processing policy we've not ever done in this country. We don't develop that agro-processing policy in line with a couple of other MDAs. And now that is really helping. In fact, the World Bank project, they support small and medium enterprises. We don't already get over about 65 SMEs then. They into various value chains. Some then they inside palm mines, some then they inside rice processing, some then they inside a couple of other things, paper processing, etc., etc. And you see, say, then support them, they not only come in the form of training, also they come in the form of grants where they support them for able to build up their own capacity and produce more. So I believe, say, and of course, we don't take a look at the trade strategy, we not ever done that. We don't develop a national trade strategy. We are almost in the final rounds of completing the special economic zone. We really, of course, it's not been done ever there. We will really can make sure, say, create that kind of environment where more and more investment will get for come into factory development.
What?
And our belief, say, by the time we go through the entire, we get them. I mean, most investors who want to come, they want to look at waiting on a policy where they speak to some of the investment they want to do. If they see, say, strong policies and they will really they speak to some of the entire, then they really see, say, then they will get the confidence for come invest. And you really want to hear more. I just tell you the rollout of the Consumer Protection Commission, where will be non-passed into law. So with all anything there, you really see, say, within a very, very short time, as a government, we don't do very, very well. I mean, point at any other government where you don't really sit down and take a look at what will they do with the policies and where really go guarantee investors and where we want to come and put the money into industry.
You don't take plenty bills them into parliament of recent. We get an agreement we get for with the brewery or yes the alcohol. Brewery agreement, and also for winner for promotes industry, and also we get other agreement them we don't lay in a parliament. Whose goods then in bills here we don't lay that parliament could bring into the industry?
Okay, take for instance which you talk about the gold brewery. Now only one brewery again in this country. A second brewery don't come. Waiting that they do, now that, I mean, a lot of people, we want to invest in them thing and they just refuse something, go, especially with that one brewery they get Sierra Leone name, just we say, we them overprotect, for instance, Sierra Leone brewery. Now they also say there is the possibility of coming to invest into a brewery factory. And this just don't stand. We need breweries across the country. We don't need people that we want for consume beer only for just kind of Sierra Leone brewery. One brew for the Nabu, one stand for the McKinney, one for the Kenema, as long as the market available. Take a look at what we don't do with the agro-processing policy. Because of that, Myro, where they plan them thing there, we don't do an agreement with the who's holding in a parliament, where they make sure, say, they establish a factory for do plywood. Thing we will not ever don't do in this country. We don't get two companies, we don't care, we don't care what the agreement in a parliament. Where they look at recycling scrap metals, all this while, with the buy scrap metal, if you forget you small and palm body self, now you backyard, somebody who can't even go sell. Now we have those, and they were exporting them. Now we have those two companies, one where almost they complete, they're far with in construction, Nasongo, where they come for recycled then scrap metal and then into steel roads. You want to really know how much impact that can forget on jobs, on cutting down on how much they import as iron rod, and possibility of even exporting within the producer of this country.
So the issue of the brewery agreement, we you say now one saloon gets and forget the second one, the issue we've been come up in parliament and the issue of the waivers them we government give to the factories during the term of operations, as then they come invest about $10 million. And according to...
And if I make you understand how they do their agreements. First, the investor comes up with a proposal. We take a look at them. Based on that proposal, we look at the existing financial acts. We'll be able to protect them, forget certain waivers, for help them come and establish their factory. Most of them factory have established. These are capital investment. You cannot spend anything below $10 million on those factories bringing them up. So we they look at, and we not just they, give them waivers. It has to be based on the law. And but then finally, pay attention, we they care about their agreements there. So the Ministry of Finance, where they get the tax experts them for look at some of the waivers they moved on.
How much the waiver the cost under this? We also the salon, the cost salon,
I cannot tell you how much that waiver will cost, but these are some of the things you do to encourage more investment in factory growth and industry development. Make a camp. I cannot tell you right now. I'm not going to tell you, say, well, the waiver, then we'll don't grant. Because most of those waivers are even based on within the financial accent. Inside the finance actually say, if you can establish a factory, you know we pay tax for all the equipment that we bring can. So if you take that and you put that inside an agreement for a factory, we only the drum for make we make sure say that factory they get the confidence or the investor get the confidence for able to do that kind of
thing. If you can invest $10 million and you waiver, for instance, go over $10 or $15 million.
No, that is not true. I mean, that's an assumption.
I'm just saying.
No, well, no,
so let me ask you, what's in the waiver?
No,
what's in the waiver? The cost.
The Ministry of Finance will get the tax expert them. Nobody look at you. They can invest $10 million, give you waiver where they're above even $2 million. It's not possible.
What's in the waiver?
Well, now they try to tell you. The Ministry of Finance get the tax experts. We cannot take an agreement without having a concurrence from the Ministry of Finance. And the tax experts in there, no, go sit down. You can't invest $10 million. They even give you a waiver. We go amount to more than $1 or $2 million. It's not possible.
So for listeners, what's in that waiver?
So this is what I'm saying. We have to go down, sit down. I mean, this takes a whole lot of waiting. I mean, you got to take a look at waiting. I mean, and even when we not do the agreement, I want to make you understand. Even when we not do the agreement, we get finance access. Not to this government, no more can develop finance act. Finance acts have been developed by several other governments prior to this time. We grant industry waivers.
My point, Mr. Minister, this is not a proposal again, that like a bill where somebody would think, say, the minister for the imposition for waiting to waiver the cost.
No, you cannot tell me waiting to waiver the cost, especially at a time like this. You have to sit down now, you look at all it, and I believe, say, the experts in the Ministry of Finance. After they don't sit down, then go into all which intake for support that industry. No, go sit down, you can't invest $10 million and go give you waiver, where even they up to $1 million.
Mr. Minister, let's look at the reality of the different agreements here where you don't get with different international business partners them for car with different factories and also industry them. The last time you also talk about a factory will go and begin produce iron rod and other things. But most of they get you. You always say very soon. This very soon, when you go be reflective, when people go see all the agreements you don't sign with factories and company them, be reflect.
Top two. First of all, whenever I read it about reality, I'm always scared. I don't know who's there in reality.
No, but when they show, they don't show it.
Well, this factory is going on. The development of this factory, they go on currently in Asongo. If you want me to take you as a team for go see the facility within the Pan Construct, I can take you there. You go, you see how far the progress. And I want to make you understand, say, when you develop a factory, you know, just come in a month, you develop a factory. You have a whole lot of engineering really put into the construction of a factory for make sure, say, the factory integrity day, for look at a couple of environmental issues, then where you really want for note while you go into operation. And I believe, say, when I tell you, say, very soon, I tell you about very soon within the context of how factories and they come about. And as I speak to you, I'm monitoring almost the activities of those people on a daily basis.
Okay.
And they don't go very, very far with the construction.
Okay, inside the program now, they come after you, Minister of Together and Industry, Dr. Edward Inga Sandi. We don't give you an update so far about different things them with people they use and need in their everyday life. The program, Good Morning Salon, they continue. And inside the program now, we they look at another issue. Some people where they do business have kitong and sell things for it, don't say. One big challenge where they get in a price control, we know they. We make them call on government for address price control in the country. Well, then people here talk more about this and other issues that are affecting business. So we intern reporter Usman and Sumana Bangora inside this Vox Pop.
And the price control, let them put their freedom and the business them talk. Because where they talk with the sellers there, and they say that the price control is attacking. So my 7,000 container and they pay how many $1,000? And we right now, some of the company are don't stop for sale. And the commission has given the Dinoa seller pay. Because the first price don't cost 400. We are selling right now 14. So don't see any. For right now, I got to get money. They happen to go up. We may know they sell one, but maybe we get enough. But therefore, take care of kingdom. We owe. Some of the women say, now we owe the home. So it's not go easy. We will break up our government. Let the price control them. Turn down the water key. Declaring more. And then they fire. But then they say, now water key. Custom. You ever pay now? You ever pay this? I will not understand. So they preach up our government. Tell them make things easier.
So what do you think say governments will do for solve this problem?
A government talk to the one the way they count the apple. Then let them all the businesses take to rest. Let them go back now wataki. Let them see how them go amend the situation. Because me left me suppose no go pull in money. I mean 1,000 you go buy where it can, then can't ask price for that. It's a fact they put in price up. But me, the only solution, let price control them. Because when price control now, they all man they do what you want. I don't know how they make the government. They put to the price control day. Then be fixed.
Well, the price got control and all stable. The price then just they go up at the shop them. We don't know what's the problem. But we believe, say, if the government snap for we, the price then goes stable. We buy, we market, sell a cow, and we buy it today. Because now you hold 1 million for go buy market. You know they see the kind market where they go buy. And where you buy at the end of the day, you know they get no profit inside it. The price, will they tell governments to make them try for you? Let them put this price control there, so let the price be stable now the market. So that we sell for we they sell, we will get straight to the get for the business. But right now, we they sell no more.
So what do you think say go solve this problem as well?
Well, this problem, what me think say go solve and at the government. And then for stand for we for let this problem also go solve. Because our price them in day before, not to surprise them. They every day, where you sleep, you wake, you meet another price. Where you sleep, you wake, you meet another price. So the price they not stable every day. They're not at 20,000 and go at 30,000. So even where they go buy the market, be in a shop where you can put some. You sell, you see, say it's slow. The goods and the day, so say, but who markets and now they go put in for where you can allow
cities. What do you think about the different prices of goods then?
Well, the difference of the prices there, it's great. Then now they even add 1,000, add then 10,000, 5,000 for one goods. So now they go find out, say, go hold 30,000 units without you not get cool, you not get rest.
They're able
for manager and cook. But now, where you own 50,000, you know they have set for cook for you plus as I know we say you buy rest inside it. Now where you want cook for you, you picking and also not very full, 100,000. And the cost of living is so too hard for let you go get 100,000 for making you eat.
Well, that's now voice of some people that will be talk to Radio Democracy. Outside them, they raise concern about them business, what they do, and also talk about the price control, where they say, now one big challenge, what don't they affect them business. Well, let me raise a concern, the insight of the internal reporter, Osman Ansumana Bangura. The program, Good Morning Salon, they continue, and we come over to a studio guest.
And inside the program, then we be done, they send a text message them on 0779-81981 and also on our Facebook page. Now, time for me, we take a few messages, quick one, and reach to Minister again for response to them. This one say, Mr. Minister is, okay, Mr. Minister, I bought a rice for 520,000, so how comes you are talking about 360?
Another message, you say, Mr. Minister, when was the last time you went to the business centers themselves as to ensure that you get first-hand information rather than relying on your trade monitors?
This one says prices are not really controlled in Sierra Leone. That now from 0779-81981 line.
This one from a Facebook page, you say, the issue of comparing Sierra Leone to other countries is so not in place. We are always comparing Sierra Leone when it comes to issues when there has been no improvement. But when it comes to things that is good, we cannot say anything.
This one says, please, sir, help us with the address to the shop where the rice is sold 380 and 330.
Another message says, affordability is so challenging for the ordinary man out there. When you look at hand in power of most Sierra Leoneans, trust me, most people are not having their 3 meals per day because price hiking is always reflecting in markets and goods.
And this and one say price will continue to rise and unless a realistic view is taken on those commodities.
This other say, Mr. Minister, please outline what you've done in terms of reality on the ground to ensure that commodities are not just available but they are also affordable for the people, no matter your status. All Sierra Leoneans should be able to provide thing to eat and other things they need in their daily lives.
Well, from the text messages then, because of time, we come to the Minister of Trade, Dr. Sandy, for respond to the messages there so far.
Thank you. First, make a go to the box message one I just read. if you take a look at waiting the person they talk say price control, they go, I mean, not they because of waiting they happen and what I can understand with them. It not necessarily even means saying that tax and don't go. When the fritz and go, and then people then the way they count with them, and then they count with them through Wataki. So man not even take them time for explain, give people then say, now the fritz and we don't go up, but man can just say Wataki. And if you take a look at the tax system we'll get now the country, Sierra Leone, they do very, very well when it comes to taxes. You don't see which I just don't mention, which we don't do with even cement. I mean, rice now one commodity now we not they attract any duty, you not get any GST. We don't even go to the point flour would they bring and I don't put GST panel. Now we think about cement, we have been 20% duty and they come down to 10%. So if you take a look at all we think this government don't do, you go really no say if it was not because the money will they pay the sheep people them where they bring canting, where not to only this country, and then where they talk say, enough I may compare Sierra Leone with other country them. Where they go for go buy them thing and they not the other country. And they tell you say because that salon you come out, so where they reduce the price. So everybody are an open market. You go you buy them. And then you come with them. So somebody will come out Liberia, somebody will come out Guinea. Now the same price and they go sell them. So you realize say, and at this now we really want to make we family understand. This COVID and the way we the economy been done time, we've been supposed to don't change years ago. For bring more factory them, we're going to make sure to produce them thing the more they use. And all part of the reason we make we find ourselves in this kind of situation.
Okay.
And waiting government don't do, and like with the other person they act, waiting some of the things they more don't do, we're not tangible things. And take a look at the number of agreements that we don't do. We don't do two flour agreements where they establish flour mill. Sierra Leone flour mill been not shut down for over 30 years. We don't do an agreement, we don't revive them. Now then they produce in this country. Take a look at what we don't do with the Miro factory where they can begin produce plywood. Take a look at what we don't do with the two companies them where they can establish factories them where they recycle scrap metals. So if you take a, I mean there are so many more. Take a look at what happened with this company even in Duazakna, cold storage, we shut down. Now we don't get a number of factories them. In fact, we get a company where they even can Coca-Cola production in this country. So you really see we are moving out of our old shell. We are coming into a new Sierra Leone where they look at which we able to do with producing which we consume.
So quickly, we don't see the attendee for international trips them on intertrade fear and other things. When are the essence of them different trips and they don't attend in of terms course, of improving the industry as a whole?
Of course, part of waiting government they try for do, especially at this very, very difficult time. We go to Dubai. I get the opportunity for meet with the Minister of State for Industry. We can do one agreement where we look at preferential trade between Sierra Leone and the UAE. That one they really get for benefit Sierra Leone a whole lot. I can't talk it. We can get what you call the Turkey African Business Forum. We go there, we engage, we get a number of investors them. We don't show interest, but can do a couple of factories then. We have an engagement and they look at waiting at some of the things them way they make, if you say the environment of this country better than other country them, and I believe say based on which we don't give them a good number of them, therefore decide say, okay, well, if you say we convince what can I say them. Then, we, of course, we didn't forget the World Trade, the 12th Ministers of Trade Conference under the WTO in Geneva. We go. Unfortunately, the COVID 19, the new Omicron virus variant, we they don't discover make, then decide for postpone that particular conference. But what we've been supposed to go do there, now for talk on which countries then do with fish subsidies.
Okay.
And that one they all been for don't really help for make sure say the one them with local people then where they into fish business in this country get opportunities then we're going to make them even thrive. Yeah, I mean in the midst of the global competition where they for either fishing and the sales of fish. So I think say some of them thing that I will not do, the number of investors them we don't get. In fact, the last time we were talking, one of the investors, one can establish a pharmaceutical factory now, where they can work on that. They don't send some of the drugs them way, mostly where they consume, where they in high demand in this country. And they look at waiting and we'll put together for a factory who can operate in this country. So I think say, a number of things that don't really come out of that, their engagement, their international engagements.
Okay, plenty thank you to you. I'm Dr. Edward Ingerson, the Minister of Trade and Industry.
Yeah.
We will get inside the program Good Morning Salon for today. Well, now this edition of the program Good Morning Salon, the left you, we guest now by the Minister of Trade and Industry, Dr. Edward Ingasandi. We can talk about plan the way the ministry don't put in place, forget better price control, and also make sure say the different commodity they affordable and available, we all sell union go able provide. And now this edition of the program Good Morning Salon, the left you. Plenty thank you to the technical team, to the producer them, Alex Lawrence Koroma and Michael Sambola, that them produce this program. DJ Lava give you technical support, and also Moses Kavora and Usman Kamara make on a CV live on my Facebook page. We will bring this edition of the program Good Morning Salon come to you this Monday morning. May Nasab to you calendar say, get yourself a wonderful day.
Musa Kamara say bye-bye.